Om sthapataya cha dharmasya sarva dharma swarupine avatara varishthaya Ramakrishnaya te namaha namaste yati rajaya Vivekananda suraye sachit sukha swarupaya swamine tapaharine. My dear Swami Shivamayananda ji on the stage, and my very dear volunteer speakers, my senior monastic brothers, junior monastic brothers, and my very dear volunteer representatives from the whole of our country. I am very glad to be here to be participating in this unique function, the first of its kind being held at the Belur premises. So all of us are very lucky and privileged to be here. I am tempted, though I should not go back to the first session, I am tempted to go back to some proceedings in the first session also, where our revered Vice President Maharaj Srimad Swami Smaranandji presided, and he quoted Swami Gambhiranandaji saying that this work that we are expecting, that we have been getting, and we expect to continue to get from the volunteers, is a fifth yoga taught by Swami Vivekananda. Four yogas he himself has taught. He has added one fifth yoga, about which he himself was very proud. He used to say, this new yoga, Seva Yoga, it can be called as Seva Yoga, though Swamiji did not use that word, but he did refer to this Shivajnane Jeeva Seva ideal as a special path by which the people of this age can reach that very goal which Buddha reached through meditation, which Jesus reached through prayers. Swamiji was very proud of this fifth yoga. We can call that a Seva Yoga, and our Smaranandji made us remember this. I am tempted to say this Seva Yoga may be the synthesis of all the four yogas Swami Vivekananda himself administered. If you can think over it, we have to apply all the four yogas if we have to be real Seva Yogins. And also, I should remember these three young volunteers who spoke in the first session, Pavitra Chakravarti, Narsim Rao, Ripan Dev. There, they spoke very well, each one stressing that Swamiji's message is for all. It is a universal message we should carry, and we get joy by going to the deprived people in the rural areas. That is a very great sentiment by our volunteers. Now I come over to the session with which I am concerned. So we remember that Swami Shivamayanandaji has appreciated a great point, that volunteers who are serving in all our centers all over the country have been given a recognition here. So we all study, but all of us do require a certificate at the end of our study. Though it may be worthless, but we want a certificate, we are satisfied. So he referred to this point, that our volunteers all over, so they have been recognized here, and I add my appreciation along with his appreciation. Guru Maharaj has served all, Swami Shivamayananda was telling. You remember one very interesting incident, when Guru Maharaj was there, Keshav Chandra Sen and other people were there. One of the devotees of Keshav Chandra Sen, he came to Sri Ramakrishna and said, you see, all these people praise Keshav Chandra Sen as Gauranga himself. What would you call yourself along with him? An Advaita Acharya, Then Sri Ramakrishna immediately folded his hands and said, No. Let Keshav Chandra Sen be Chaitanya. But I am the servant of you all. So this is the attitude of Sri Ramakrishna, whom we follow, we are volunteers. So it has started, this volunteership has started from Sri Ramakrishna himself, and ideal volunteers have been there in the direct disciples, Holy Mother, etc. And volunteers, they are all devotees first and last. They are all devotees of Sri Ramakrishna, Holy Mother, Swamiji, and the Sangha, and all that stands for the Sangha. That is the real quality of our volunteers. And they stand, they are there to serve Thakur, Mother, Swamiji, the Sangha, and all that the Sangha wants to do. How do they do it? Through love. When we talk of love, love expresses itself through tyaga and seva, renunciation and service. So when we say we love Sangha, we love all that the Sangha does, that means we will be ready as volunteers to sacrifice whatever sacrifices are expected of us, required of us, and mainly the sacrifice will be of our selfish attitudes. We should remember this, that when we give up the selfishness in our attitudes, in our expressions, in our duties, in our work, then we will be doing the real tyaga. That should come into our volunteers, this selfless attitude to everything. And seva is giving joy to others, giving comfort to others, giving relief to others. It may be physical, it may be through words, sweet words, consoling words, and it may be through several types of deeds. So our volunteers should be ready for all these things. Why to become a volunteer? This beginning, when young people come, they hear from their friends, as Swami Atmavel Vidananda several times used to say, he came to be a volunteer in Bangalore center, hearing through his friends, there is something attractive there. When first a young man comes, he will have this question, why should we become a volunteer? What is the benefit? So we need not go into the philosophy of it, but Swami Vivekananda has again and again said, through his letters, through his other lectures, that whoever serves the Lord, whoever serves God, he himself, his children means all the humanity that is here, all beings that are there in front of you. Whoever serves God and God's children, he gets the grace of God, and grace of God can give you everything: bhakti, bhukti, enjoyment in this world, and the eternal joy of God. Both can come to us by getting the grace of God. Grace of God can come to us when we serve His children. So this is the main point of a volunteer's volunteering to become a volunteer. So we have very good record of volunteers everywhere. And one of the young men who spoke here, some of your volunteer representatives, he referred to that we should learn how to serve. I remember a very interesting incident in the life of one of our very, very revered Swamis, Swami Yatishwaranandji. Swami Yatishwaranandji, in his general lectures, he used to tell this incident. I, as a young man, at that time I had not joined, I appreciate this incident. What is this? He said that he was a student of chemistry, and he was passing along the streets of Calcutta, and then he found one diseased dog full of eruptions throughout its body, licking its wounds and suffering very much, very restless. So he, being a student of chemistry, suddenly thought, I can apply some medicine to relieve it from this pain. So he suddenly went to the laboratory, his chemistry laboratory, brought carbolic acid. With carbolic acid, this chemistry boy knows that it is an antiseptic. So if it is applied, some relief it can get. He brought a lot of carbolic acid and applied all over the body of that dog. And that carbolic acid may be an antiseptic, but then it increased its sort of a suffering. It went on licking much more, and all the carbolic acid from the wounds went into its stomach and it died. See, he wanted to save the dog. He did not know how to serve it. Then the doctor said, you should apply, but you should have applied such a medicine which even if it licks, it should not have died. So he used to tell this one and draw the same conclusion. We serve, it's very good, but we should know how to serve, when to serve, how much to serve. So that volunteer stressed that very good point. You all might have heard some few years back, maybe about 10 years back or 8 years back, there was a great tragedy in one of the big pilgrimage centers in the south, Tanjavur, where there is one of the biggest Shiva temples, Brihadishwara temple. They wanted to celebrate some big function there. They erected a huge pandal and conducted a yajna for which maybe about 80,000 to 1 lakh of people assembled there. And these people, to stop wind blowing and then disturbing their yajna, they closed all the doors all over, except one or two doors to enter and to get out. 1 lakh of people in a venue like this, with only one or two doors to come out, and 1 lakh people are assembled there, somehow the fire sparked, it set off fire in the campus. There was a pell-mell, people could not go here and there, where to go, all of them rushed towards one or two doors. There was stampede and hundreds of people died. So there was a big furor in the whole of South. Some of them came to me and then asked, Swamiji, what do you think that it was a big religious festival, it should have brought us all so much of joy, spiritual as well as physical also, because we are worshipping God. How did this accident happen? I asked them, how many number of volunteers did you have when you have brought 1 lakh of people on the ground for a festival? There should be somebody to guide, somebody to help them in case of such emergency. How many volunteers did you have? We had 200. I said, you should have at least had 2,000. In place of 2,000, you have got 200 volunteers. That is why this pell-mell happened. You see our functions here. When there are 4,000 people, you have got 600 volunteers here. You see, there must be people to help when we bring all people from outside to serve them. Our volunteers are the real forces that guide them well, that make this function smooth and bring joy and comfort to the whole people. So volunteers are very, very important for every organization that conducts philanthropic works, hospital, other relief work, any public service. Volunteers are the core, and our volunteers should be special volunteers. So during tsunami, you must have all heard, you have read how wonderful the Ramakrishna mission conducted the tsunami operations for one full year in 2004 to 2005, full 1 year, and we could do it in the best possible way because we had the best group of volunteers, 800 volunteers working throughout the day, throughout the year. From the beginning, at 9:30 tsunami started in Chennai, we started our relief work at 11 o'clock on the same day. And it went on for full years. And we were only a few Swamis, maybe a dozen Swamis, who did all so much of work in 5 campuses spread over the whole of Tamil Nadu. From Raipuram, from Kalpakkam in Madras, and to Nagapattinam, and to Kadalur, and to Kanyakumari, to the southern end. Whole thing was managed so well. The papers wrote, Ramakrishna Mission is the first organization to construct 110 houses in 105 days and hand it over to the people. How could it be possible? Not through the Swamis. Of course, by the grace of Guru Maharaj, Holy Mother, Swamiji is there. But that we did not see. But we saw 800 volunteers working from morning till evening with that spirit of dedication, spirit of seva, spirit of tyaga. This is the great work of the volunteers, and I am so glad that you have all come here and you have been recognized, your work, greatness of your work, the worth of your work from the spiritual point of view is really great. So you have all come here, we are seeing you, we are very happy. And in today's deliberations, we have heard Vishwanjan Satpati, Deepak Kamat, Kaushik Bhai Goswami, Vivek Sharma, Shambhuna Datta, and of course our Swamiji, Swami Atmavidanandaji, and Shishurangan Vairagi, Daya Prasad, all of them expressing wonderful ideas. These, that means our volunteers are really are getting geared up for the work they have done. Some of them have spoken so nicely that we should know the ideals of volunteers. We should cultivate qualities of ideals, the cultivate certain qualities as volunteers. And then one person has said, he gave a story, wonderful story. There were three God-realized persons, and the God-realized person who went to serve the suffering people was considered the best Vijnani, what Sri Ramakrishna would call. He saw God inside himself, he saw God outside. So our volunteers represent this Vijnani message of Sri Ramakrishna. And another volunteer said, so Swami Vivekananda made a revolutionary move when he added Jagadhitaya to Atmano Moksha. Atmano Moksha was our Moksha ideal. It is thousands of year old ideal everyone likes. But Swamiji made it into a revolutionary idea by adding this Moksha itself will be hurried, will be brought to you earlier, much quicker, with an easier means if you serve the world with the idea that Shiva Jnane Jiva Seva. See, God alone lives in everyone. So that is a wonderful idea. He said, similarly, service is worship. If you bring it out, this attitude, change your attitude, that it is not service, it is worship. Worship of whom? Worship of God. Worship of God can bring you joy in this world and your moksha also. This wonderful point was stressed by Swami Atmavidanandaji. So, and another one young man said, we should know the life and teachings of the trio also. Then we grow through this knowledge and we grow in our service attitude also. And all these ideas expressed by the volunteers and some of our Swamis, all this will go to make us better volunteers, better servants of Sri Ramakrishna, Holy Mother and Swamiji. And I pray to Sri Ramakrishna, Holy Mother and Swami Vivekananda to bless us all in every way and make our coming here successful, useful, and take us to higher progress in our life. Thank you very much.